1月份 McKinsey 出咗個 report 話俾我哋聽咧，有 70% 嘅 customer 都 require 一個 more personalised interaction， 或者喺過去嗰兩年咧都曾經轉個 brand 轉個 platform 去買嘢。而家嘅 customer 佢對於一個 brand 或者一個 product 佢哋嘅要求同喺 COVID 之前咧應該係有好大嘅落差。以前可能會 care about 你到底係咪一個大 brand， 你出唔出名。而家佢哋可能考慮嘅因素咧就會唔同啦。 佢會諗下你嘅品牌係咪有一個環保嘅元素喺入邊啦？你哋對於 employee caring 係咪做得好足啦？等等嘅因素。咁當然啦，喺我買你哋嘅 product 同埋 service 嘅同時，你係咪能夠提供足夠嘅 flexibility 同埋 tailoring？On the other hand， 我哋睇翻我哋嘅 sales 同埋 business development team， 佢哋以前嘅 edge 可能會係我掌握緊好多資訊。我哋公司嘅 service 同埋 product 咧，我哋嘅 spec 係最清楚、最新、最 update。 當然啦，都仲有我哋同 customer 嘅關係嘅。咁但係喺過去嗰兩年，由於商業活動普遍係減少咗啦，其實唔多唔少 sales team 或者 BD team 佢哋嘅 selling practice 亦都會少咗 training。咁喺當我將兩樣嘢擺埋嘅時候咧，我哋就會發覺 customer value 嘅嘢有不同，但係我哋 sales team 到底能唔能夠可以將突出到呢一個 competitive advantage 唔再係 information， 而係一個 sentimental connection、 storytelling ability， 或者真係可以 click 到呢一個世代 consumer 佢哋需要嘅嘢咧？咁所以我相信咧喺2022年咧，大部分嘅商業機構佢哋都一定會 revisit 佢自己嘅 service 同埋佢嘅 customer offering。 到底我應該點樣去同我嘅客户溝通咧？或者我嘅 brand narrative 係咪 match 緊而家呢一個世代嘅 consumer 佢哋嘅需要？